everybody that doesn't know, this is Andes from Touchstone, our UK heart partner. And Touchstone have been a partner for over 10 years, but Andes will tell you a bit more about that. And I just wanted to get some thoughts from you on TimeXtender as a partner and some of the impact and the influence that we've had on Touchstone.
Thanks very much for inviting me, Louise, to say a few words and have this conversation with you. TimeXtender, as you say, we've been involved with it 10 years. I mean, just a bit of background, I guess, from Touchstone. We're a reseller of financial management systems, CRM systems, procurement systems. So our whole ethos is going to customers and understanding what their requirements are, what they're looking for, and we propose, you know, it's commonly known as best of breed. So we'll put together a number of applications to try and solve a particular issue or meet the requirements that they have. And some years ago, we came across TimeXtender through another OEM partner called Jet, who resold TimeXtender as part of their solution for Dynamics solutions like Dynamics Nav and AX and Great Plains. And I used to run the Great Plains business at Touchstone. We also have another financial management system called Sun Systems. And we thought, well, actually, it's a good platform, actually, in terms of what we can take to our customers. They've got multiple data sources. They want to bring it all to one place. And this, you know, it looked a neat tool, you know, some 10 years ago. So we worked with TimeXtender to build the Sun Systems adapter so that we could go to our customers and talk to them about, well, they've got Sun Systems, they might have Salesforce, they might have another CRM system, they might have a project system. And we would say, well, in order to get all that data together, rather than use the plethora of spreadsheets that you currently do, which, you know, can be unreliable and, you know, unpredictable, why don't you bring them all into one data warehouse? And we have a solution for you. And we named it ourselves, we called it ETL Agile. So our customers, quite a lot of our customers, who've been using TimeXtender for quite a number of years now, have ETL Agile, underpinned, obviously, by TimeXtender. And so we've grown the BI business on the back of that over the last years, and we go to market in a number of ways. We either go to our customers with ETL Agile. We have customers who have TimeXtender, as you would know it, on premise. And now, you know, exciting times now, we're moving a lot more of our customers and engaging more customers out on the cloud. So we've got the later version of TimeXtender. So TimeXtender has formed an integral part of our solution and our platform, where we can go to our customers, where we can deliver and deploy line of business applications like finance and CRM procurement. But from a reporting perspective, from a data perspective, we've got a part of that jigsaw is we have a platform to automate all the data collection, if you like, into one place, so we can help them then surface that information out through spreadsheets or dashboards or reporting platforms like Power BI and such like. So from a business perspective, you know, it's been really exciting to be, you know, going along the TimeXtender journey, because, you know, it takes us into areas that we traditionally weren't in. For example, we hadn't integrated with other financial management solutions, you know, things like Sage or Open Accounts or SAP. But now we're talking to customers who, you know, don't have our finance system, have different systems. So we're talking to them very much from a data perspective. And that's where the Touchstone BI, who I look after, is evolving into a data management BI practice. And, you know, and at the centre of that is TimeXtender.
Brilliant. And so I think that's been really helpful to understand, and certainly an exciting journey for us to come along with you. And so is it then clear to say that when you're approaching your customers, you operate in a challenge-based environment? So there's a potential issue or a potential challenge that a customer is facing, and instead of proposing a piece of software, actually you try and solve the problem that they have?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we've always been, and it is commonly known as, you know, solutions sales, where where a customer has a, you know, requirement. You know, it could have been a fairly straightforward requirement. I need a new accounting system because my old one doesn't work. Or I've grown, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 times the size, and I need to get a better one that's more capable for the type of business I am. But customers, you know, and our go-to-market strategy has always been about, you know, outcomes. What are we trying to achieve? What is the customer trying to achieve? What benefits can we bring to them? And what value can we add as quickly as possible? And that's really how we're measured. We're not really measured on, well, how good was our training, or how, you know, how well did we consult there? It's basically, did we achieve the ultimate objective for that customer in terms of business? You know, it could be anything from increased efficiency, you know, more throughput through sales, or cost savings, or, you know, being able to disperse information, you know, much quicker, so their stakeholders around the business can, you know, make decisions. So our approach is very much business outcomes, but it's not just reading off a piece of paper. It's really getting close to our customers and understanding why, you know, they want to do that. So we do a lot of questioning. Why would you want to do that? Why do you think that might make it better? You know, we've got several hundred customers, and we've got customers that have been with us for, you know, from a TouchstoneBI perspective, for almost 30 years. So we pride ourselves on being, if you like, the customer's trusted advisor. So that's really our approach to, you know, our customers.
Yeah. And one thing you mentioned there were your consultants. And so a question from me then would be, has the TimeXtender suite, whether that's, you know, all the way back in the day of Jet and then ETO Agile through to the TimeXtender on-prem licenses that you have, has that allowed you to increase your consulting practice?
Yes, I mean, it's allowed us to build, you know, what was a one-man, you know, consultancy, you know, to, you know, a, you know, a 6, 7, 8 man consulting team,
yeah,
that can, you know, needs to implement data solutions. So it's just not, they need a data warehouse, we put it there and off you go. It is the consulting team around it. Because when I talk about business outcomes, I don't need just a technical person to orchestrate all of the data, and that's your job. They really need to be cognizant of what the customer is trying to achieve. So therefore needing to ask the right questions, so the data is curated in the right way in order to give them that outcome. So you need some experience, general business experience, general accounting experience. So our consultants have come from our business practice, as well as augmenting it by some techies. But as you well know, TimeXtender doesn't require, you know, loads and loads of technical IT skills. In fact, that's one of the unique selling points that we take to a customer. So you don't need a massive IT department. It puts data in the hands of the business analyst and the end user, rather than it's all in the domain of IT. So that's really how we've gone to market a lot of the time. Why, you know, saying this isn't a black art. This is a very straightforward orchestration tool of data that makes it available for your stakeholders to then present out as necessary. And so that sort of applies to us internally, that we've been able to use our business consultants to get, you know, get their heads around and handle around the some of the techniques within TimeXtender, so they then can have a very informed conversation with the customer. Say, right, okay, well, I'm looking for this report, but wouldn't it be good if I could have that? Well, okay, yeah, I understand what you're trying to get to. I know that data is actually held in this CRM system. You need to combine it with your project system, and I can give you all of that in one report. And that's where and how the conversations go. So we haven't really gone down the, oh, we must build a technical team. We've continued on our path of a business solutions team that just so happens to have TimeXtender as part of the solution. And most of our proposals go out with TimeXtender in there. What, you know, as in a why wouldn't you line?
Yeah.
Why wouldn't you want to combine all your multiple data sources into one in a very well managed data platform, so that you can have a 360-degree view of your business. You know, one source of truth, accessible by whatever means, and so that so that goes under the why wouldn't you line.
Brilliant.
Of the proposal.
I love it. Mm. And I think it's probably interesting for the audience to know that you actually use TimeXtender internally as well.
Yes, yeah, very interesting. Yeah, we do actually. I mean, and for the audience, I guess if they are other partners, they're probably similar to us. They have customers, they have projects, they'll have a CRM system, they will have a finance system, they will have, you know, maybe an order processing system, and we implemented TimeXtender some time ago, probably for internal use. It probably started with the consultants probably just wanting to have a play with it and see how it worked. So obviously we use Sun, so we connected to Sun. We have a project system called Time at Work. We connect to that. We have Dynamics CRM. We can connect to that. We have a workflow system for all the processing called Flowcentric. We connect to that. What we're able to do is have literally a 360-degree view of a customer. For example, from our CRM, I can get pipeline information. I can see what order is about to close. I can see from my project system, what projects have I got on the go? What consultants have I got on that particular project? I can connect it to our support system called Freshdesk, which then gives me my outstanding support calls. And it also tells me what maintenance I'm charging that particular customer for the group of products they have. And it connects to the finance system, so I can see how much that particular customer spent with us over the years, and actually how much they owe us in terms of aged debt. We used to have, we had the TimeXtender. We had, and it also provides, if you like, analysis services cubes for specific areas. So operationally, if we've got our services team, they look at the services cube. Our sales analysis team, they look at that cube. You know, that was, if you like, put together by our guys, and it was, and so we've been using that for quite a number of years. We used for a lot of years a product called Target, which was a really neat dashboard front end tool that we used. And then probably a couple of years ago, we stopped using Target. We had to. It was quite abrupt in terms of the close. We couldn't use it anymore. And so we had a matter of, I would say, 3 weeks to convert all our Target reports to Power BI, which we did over the Christmas period without having to touch the data. And that's one of the great benefits of TimeXtender. We go and talk to customers, and it doesn't matter if you decide to change your reporting tool from Tableau to Power BI, from Excel or Target, the data stays the same. We just repoint it and off you go. And that took, and so that's quite an impressive piece of work we did internally. I'm quite pleased with ourselves actually.
Yeah.
And we can use that as an example of how speedily you can change from one platform to another.
And I think that's really nice to hear that you're using the experience that you've had with the product yourselves as a user, as a business user, that you can then push that out to your customer base or your potential customer base with that use case.
Well, that's right. And it's sometimes, you go to customers and say, oh, well, we use this. And they, you're just saying that. But no, we actually present our reporting platform to them. And say, no, this is where all the data comes from. And a lot of them can obviously relate.
Yeah, it brings it to life.
It brings it to life. And, when you talk about things that it comes across pretty quite compelling sometimes. I didn't know you'd do that. We often leave them some idea what can be achieved, and then our next step is normally we'll talk to them about proof of concept. We'll try before you buy, because we're very confident that if you gave our consultants a couple of days, give us a couple of your data sources, in those couple of days we'll have be able to present to you the combination of that data into the reporting platform that you want. And the great thing that we about TimeXtender is that we don't call it a demo. We're not coming into demo. It's almost the start of the implementation, because whatever we leave you with is what we start building on. So you don't, you know, because it's about pointing to the data sources. You don't have to redo that again. You know, you'll make, you know, you create some warehouses. You might, you know, make some analysis service queues or whatever you need, and then that's there. And they again, that's quite compelling. That, you know, they, and you know, we bring the customer along with us. You know, and then they leave them to play for a couple of weeks, and then we go back and do the full implementation.
So if we think about the future, the future right now, the immediate future. Obviously, we've added a couple of products into our portfolio, which is quite exciting, and we'll start to discuss those. And the future of the product. So, as you said, we moved from an on-prem solution to a SaaS version. And so, I guess the future development of the partnership can be quite exciting. We're trying to evolve the product and the product set. And so, hopefully, you see that with us as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's undeniable the amount of effort and time and thought and developments going into the application. You know, it's just interesting to see. And like most software authors, you have to be a one step ahead of us as partners, because we have to obviously relate what you're doing back to our customers' requirements and what the outcomes are. So we want to make sure that you're headed in the right direction, so that when the question comes down, what are we going to do about this, what are we going to do about AI, what about data governance and those sort of conversations that we will have, and then in reselling, as we do, it's all about backing the right horse and, you know, staying in it for the long term. And so it's, you know, it's very, very comforting to see that, you know, your roadmap and the plans that you have for the further development of the product, because we know we'll be able to then take that to market in terms of, you know, maybe the independence of databases, which is really what our message is. We're sort of independent of the application platform. We just want to get the right solution for you. We just happen to have some of the best applications in our kit bags.
I think that's a great place to end. Thank you very much, Anders.
Thank you.